Christina, and I am back, and I'm here with a very fun tutorial for you guys today. It is doing this 3D halo blue smoky eye, and I absolutely love how this turned out. I was conceptualizing it in my head for a while. I was like, I want to do an all matte look with a white in the center, so it gives this 3D effect to the eye. And when you do all matte on the lids, it really gives this airbrushed effect, and add in the white will give this 3D effect. So I was like, I am doing it, and I am so happy with how it turned out. So if you want to see how I did this look step by step, then stay tuned and I'll talk to you soon.
Hey there, guys. So let's get right into it. As usual, I start out with my brows and I apply some eyeshadow primer around my brows. I do recommend the NARS Smudge Proof eyeshadow base for this purpose, and I'm just brushing that through using a handy dandy toothbrush. Now I'm going in with my brow beater brow pencil from Urban Decay, and this is the shade Dark. I went with dark versus neutral brown, which is my favorite color, but I decided that I could go a little bit more intense with my brows today, so I'm using the darker color. And I'm just going to outline my brows with this pencil and feather it through some of the hairs to fill in any sparse areas and to create a defined shape to the brows. And if you guys are interested in seeing a full brow tutorial, I do have one linked below in the description box, so you can definitely check that out if you're interested. But all I do is fill in my brows with my brow pencil, and then I'll use the spoolie side of the pencil to just work some of the product through the brow hairs, as well as groom all the hairs in place in the shape that I prefer. And now I'm grabbing my Paula Dorf Eye Definer brush, which is just a flat top brush, and I use the pencil to work the product through the brow hairs and blur the lines that we created with the pencil, because we don't want the lines to show because it will look too harsh. Next, I'll grab my brow powder duo in the shade Ebony. This is from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm just grabbing some of the lighter side of the duo on that Paula Dorf brush and working it through the brow hairs, and this is going to diffuse the product even more and soften up the shape so it looks a lot more natural and less defined. And I think it's a good brow day. Next, I'm going in with my MAC Prep and Prime 24-Hour Extend Eye Base, and I'm just going to apply this all over my lids, and this is going to help prevent our eyeshadows from creasing since I do have very oily lids. Then I'm going to grab my Bright Future Gel Serum Concealer from Sephora, and this is the shade number 12, Cream Cafe, and I'm just going to apply that directly beneath my brows to help clean up the shape and act as a highlight. And I am going to use my number 18 concealer brush from Anastasia Beverly Hills to create a nice defined shape to the underside of the brow and also help blend this color down just a touch. And this brush is perfect for this because it has a nice defined shape, so it creates a nice sharp line. Next, I'm grabbing my Real Techniques Deluxe Crease brush, and I'm going to use this brush just to blend out the edges of the concealer and to really work the excess product around on my lids and on my brow bone area, because too much of this cream product can cause creasing, so you want to really blend it out and create just a light wash. And here's an up close view of the look that we're going for. I completed one side and we're going to jump into the other side right now. I'm grabbing my Kat Von D High Voltage Eye Primer in the shade Skin. This is just a light beige color, and I really love this primer for bright looks. It really picks up color and really intensifies bright colors. So if you're looking for a nice primer, I would go with this one. Not her new stick primers at all. I don't like those, but this one is perfect. I'm grabbing a blending shade. This is my nude eyeshadow from Smashbox. I don't think they sell this anymore, and that's quite a shame because it's perfect. And I'm just going to blend that in my crease area and my brow bone with a blending brush from Chikuhodo, and just blend it back and forth to create a nice wash of color. Now we're going in with the star of the show. This pigment is 156 Body Pigment from Inglot. And I'm grabbing it on a J242G eye shader brush from Hakuhodo. It's a very small shader brush, and this color is so beautiful. It's like a matte cerulean blue, and I'm creating a shape on the inner lid and outer lid area. I'm just patting this color on to get all the intensity that I can, and I'm just building up the color. I'm keeping the inner tear duct free though of color, And now I'm grabbing a J5523 blending brush from Hakuhodo and just blending out the edges of the color. And I'm very lightly bringing this into the crease area. I am not blending it too much. I'm just trying to buff out the color so it doesn't have harsh lines. And then I grab a little bit of the pigment directly on the blending brush and go around the edges. And this is going to create more of a diffused look and help us blend out the edge of the color that we laid down before on the inner and outer lid. And you just go back and forth. I cleaned off the excess off the brush and I'm just going in and blending. And this takes time, so be very patient, especially with matte pigments. This is a matte bright blue and it's going to take some time to blend out, so be very patient. I did a lot of blending here, just going back and forth, picking up a little color and just blending as we go. Now I'm going to pick up some more of the pigment and build up the pigmentation that we lost while we were blending it out. So I'm just tapping some more of the color over those areas and then going back in with the blending brush and going very lightly around the edges just to fade out any harsh lines. Next, I'm grabbing my number 35 pigment from Inglot. This is a matte white shade. And I'm going in with a matte 239 brush. This is just an eye shader brush. And I'm just tapping that directly in the center of where we place the blue. And this is just going to give us nice, intense white pop on the center. And it's going to create a 3D effect, which is really beautiful. And I'm just going back in with the brush that we use for the blue and blending back and forth. So I'm packing on some more blue color and just going back and forth between the white and the blue. And I'm using those brushes just to blend out the edges of the color and blur the blue and the white together. Now I'm grabbing Rich Navy, which is number 36 from Bobbi Brown. This is just a matte, deep navy shade. And my Sonia Kashuk Large Crease Brush. And I'm just going to pop this on the outer lid area and build up that intensity. And this brush is perfect for this because it has a nice rounded dome shape that keeps it concentrated but helps you to pack on color and create intensity. Now I'm going back in with the Hakuhodo blending brush and blending out the edge of that color. Now again, these are matte colors, so you do have to be very patient and go back and forth, grab a little bit more of the color and really buff out the edge of the color. And I'm using circular motions back and forth, windshield wiper motions, just to buff out the color and create a gradient effect and a nice blown out effect on the brow bone area. And again, just be very patient and really focus on blending. I'm grabbing a makeup wipe and just removing some of the excess eyeshadow just to clean up the shape. Nothing too crazy. And my highlight shade today is Mirage Eyeshadow from Makeup Geek. And I'm using a matte 252 large shader brush for this. This is a really beautiful eyeshadow. It works beautiful as a highlight. And I'm going to grab some of that color on a bullet brush or a pencil brush and pop it on my inner tear duct area to act as a highlight on that area. And after this, I decided I was going to add a little bit more to the other side because I wanted to build up the intensity. And you just want to pop that on the inner tear duct and blend out the edges. I'm just using my Chukuhodo number GSN 10 blending brush for this. Let's go ahead and do some face work. We're using the Pore Sebum Control Moisture Stick from Cow Lion. This is a Sephora brand. It's pretty new, and I'm just applying that to my T-zone area and blending it in using my fingers. This is meant to control oil breakthrough and provide a nice matte base for our foundation. And for my foundation today, I'm using the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay In Place Makeup in the shade 5N1 Ginger. And you can see this is a great shade match for me because you can't even see where it shows up on my skin. I'm blending that in using my Marc Jacobs number 3, the face brush. And I really like how this foundation is applying and how it matches my skin. Again, the neutral shades in most foundations tend to match me pretty well. Now I'm grabbing my Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Aqua Sela Concealer. This is the shade Deep. And I'm going to pop that beneath my eyes as a highlight. I'm also going to add the shade Tan just to blend that in. This is going to conceal and add just a little bit of brightness because it is a little lighter than my skin, but not too light and bright because I don't do that overly highlighted look, and just blend it in with the foundation brush. And of course, I'm going to set everything down using my Naked Skin Ultra Definition Powder Foundation in the shade Medium Dark Golden. And I don't use too much of this powder. I'm just pouncing it over my skin using my Tarte S Powder Player Large Kabuki Brush just to bounce that in and set everything in place. Now I'm going in with my mascara for my upper lash line. This is my Too Faced Better Than Sex. What else would you expect me to be using? This is my all-time favorite mascara, and I'm just making sure that I coat all the lashes and make sure they stand out against that bright blue in the background. And I'm going to line my upper lash line today, which I haven't done in the longest time. I'm using my Marc Jacobs Magic Marker Precision Pen. This is in the shade Blacker. And I'm just creating a very subtle winged liner. And I really love this liquid liner. It's one of my favorites. It's a little bit pricey, but it works so well and it hasn't dried out. And I've had it for a while. And it's just rich and black and it dries matte and it stays in place all day. For my lower waterline, I'm using my Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Eye Pencil in the shade Perversion, which is just a matte black. And I love this pencil again for my waterline. Then I'm grabbing the number 63 Pigment from Inglot. It's a shimmery copper shade. And I'm grabbing a little bit of my Illamasqua Eye Seal Gel on my MAC 242 brush. And I'm going to pop this pigment on my lower lash line. This is such a coppery, glittery, beautiful shade. I love this pigment so much. And then once we're done with that, I'm grabbing my eyelashes. This is the eyelashes from House of Lashes in the style Temptress. How many times can I say lashes? I'm just going to pop that on my upper lash line using my Revlon Lash Glue, which again is my favorite lash glue. And then for my lower lashes, I'm using my MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash Mascara, which again, another favorite. I'm going in with my Inglot number 30 pigment to pop that on my inner tear duct using my pencil brush, because I just thought that inner tear duct needed some fun. And this pigment is beautiful. It reflects a little bit of like a light green and a gold. It's so beautiful, and I'm just gonna blend that out just to blend it in with the eye color that we have on the lid and pull it down on the inner lower lash line as well. And I'm gonna blend that out using the Chikuhodo GSN number 10 brush again, just to make sure everything flows together and it's seamless. And I love how this eyeshadow turned out. As you can see, it's just this 3D effect. It's really beautiful. It looks airbrushed. I love it. Continuing with the face, we're using my NARS pressed powder in the shade Valley and my Chanel number 3 contour brush, and just creating a very light shade in the cheek area. I'm creating a very subtle contour. I don't like harsh contour at all, so I go with a shade that's just a little bit darker than my skin, and applying it also to my temple area and hairline. Now I'm going to grab my blush. This is the shade Devil from MAC. It's one of their Pro Longwear blushes, and I'm using my Zoeva blush brush just to pop that on my cheeks. It's a matte orangey shade, but it has a little bit of golden shimmer to it. So it blends out mostly matte, but it gives a very skin-like finish because it has a little bit of that sheen to it. And it is so beautiful on darker skin. This is a blush that I highly recommend. I'm going to try out one of my new highlighters. This is the shade Indiscretion from Laura Mercier. It's one of her new illuminators. I'm just going to pop that on my cheek hair area and right along my hairline. This is the MAC number 133 brush, which I really like for highlight. This worked really well. And now I'm going to also create a little bit of dimension on my nose using that same Valley Press Powder from NARS. And I'm using one of my Smith Cosmetics brushes. This is the 124. It's just a small contour brush. And I'm just going to apply the color using that brush and then blending it out using my Tarte Powder Player brush, because I hate when there are harsh lines on the nose area. It's just too harsh for me and I have to blend that out. So I'm just buffing it in. And then I'm grabbing my lipstick, which is Eat Cake from Marc Jacobs. It's one of the nude shades. And I'm just going to pop that on my lips. I really love this color as well. It's one of my favorite spring and summer shades. It's really lightweight and just a very subtle color. And then I'm going to outline my lips using my Bittersweet Pro Longwear Lip Pencil from MAC. It's just a rich, dark brown shade. And I'm just using this to create a little bit of dimension to the lip so the lip color blends a little bit more nicely. Then I'm grabbing the shade Salamanca from NARS. This is one of their lip glosses. And just popping that over the lips to give it a more glossy look. And I absolutely love this look. I love how it turned out. And I love playing with color. You guys know how I love color. So this look is just right up my alley. And I hope you guys enjoyed it as well and will try it out. I am going to do more of these bright looks because I'm feeling bright looks and I'm so happy for the warmer weather. So stay tuned.
All right, right, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial as much as I enjoyed putting it together. It's a really fun look for me, and it's really colorful, and it's bringing me right into the mood for spring and summer, and I can't wait for the bright sunshine. And it's finally warming up a bit, so I'm really excited about things. And this look is just, yes. It's doing things for me, and all the products that I use actually worked out really well, and I'm very happy with this foundation so far. So I'm gonna test this out for wear time and see what I think, but so far I am liking it and I just love this look. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it as well. As usual, I'll leave a full list of the products used down below in the description box. So if you missed anything, definitely check below. And I'll leave helpful links as well to my Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook page where you can follow me along. And until my next video, which will be very soon, I'll talk to you. Bye, guys.